SimCity 5 cannot be fixed. It is broken by design, and here's why in a nutshell. First, there are many problems with SimCity. This here just focuses on why the general approach of SimCity does not work. It's not about the other problems like server issues, always online DRM, or bad pathfinding and bugs. Here's why it cannot work. The promise of SimCity 5 is to simulate everything you see down to single sims by the agent system. So, like in the real world, the traffic on the road is the product from sims going to work, grocery shopping, or whatever people drive around for. Let's look at the real world. Let's look at a town of roughly 50,000 inhabitants, like this one here. This is Speyer in Germany. Now imagine you are living somewhere near the city center, close to a moderately busy one-way, one-lane road. When you look out of your living room window, you can observe that on average every 10 seconds a car is passing in front of that window at about 50 kilometers an hour. That gives us a distance of 138 meters from car to car. I'd say you find busy roads in every city that size, especially during rush hour, so this is an admissible example. We now will try to simulate this in SimCity. At SimCity Llama speed, the time runs about 30 times faster than in real life without accelerating the physics, meaning the cars. The traffic remains the same in the sim world as in reality, since the population has to go to work in the morning, return in the evening, and go shopping or pursue recreational activities, despite the fact that their SimCity day only has 48 minutes. So we now have to put the same amount of traffic into a 48-minute day without speeding the cars up. When we look out of our window in this situation, we see a car passing every 0.3 seconds at 50 km per hour, and that results in an average distance from exhaust to exhaust of 4.6 meters. Does that sound like a problem to you? There's nothing to worry about yet. According to Wiki Answers, we are still fine since the average car length is 4.12 meters, giving us a space of 48 centimeters between the rear bumper of a car and the front bumper of the car behind it, both driving at 50 km per hour. So all you need to make this work right now are very observant drivers with extremely good reactions. By the way, if we change to the medium or cheetah speed setting, nothing changes since the simulation not only compresses the time fourfold for the medium setting, it also increases the speed of the physics engine, meaning the speed of the cars, by 4 to compensate for that. The cars only move at 200 for the player outside the simulation. Inside the simulation we still see them driving at 50 since the time is running 4 times faster for us. The important thing is, the separation stays the same. Now, where is the problem, you might ask? Well, the problem is that our assumptions are very conservative. As we have seen, we cannot simulate significantly more cars on our road than one every 10 seconds at 50, because otherwise the cars start to touch each other. Now, a car passing by every 10 seconds at 50 equals a maximum capacity of less than 400 cars per hour per lane, but the maximum capacity of a real-world inner-city lane at 50 is about 1,600 cars per hour. That's more than 4 times the cars our simulated road can handle. For freeways, it gets even worse, because according to Scientific American, the standard freeway lane can handle 2,000 cars per hour, and the spatial compression of SimCity exacerbates the problem even further. Why can't that be fixed somehow? Here are some solutions that would work but are not feasible. First, grab the problem at the root, which is the times 30 compression. If we ditch that and make the SimCity day 24 hours long, all is fine. Unfortunately, that would make for a very boring game. 2. Speed up the cars 30 times to compensate. The cars are now going at 1,500 km per hour and are not really visible anymore. Sort of defeats the purpose of having them driving around at all. Besides, the constant sonic booms would not make for a pleasant city to live in. 3. Have more lanes. For every real-world lane, we need 4 SimCity lanes to achieve the same overall capacity. That would work, but it makes for a horrible-looking city. 4. Compress the cars 30 times. By compressing the cars, I don't mean compressing the visual size of the cars, although that would work as well, but to have one SimCity car for every 30 real cars. What Maxis has done in an attempt to make it work is probably a mixture of small amounts of the above and in part liable for the strange sightings one can make while playing. For example, they did compress the cars a bit, but the problem with that is that it can't be done uniformly. If the cars are compressed by a factor of 10, small low-density houses with only a couple of families don't emit any cars anymore, which would look very unrealistic, so the compression for the cars emitted from low-density buildings has to be lower than the compression for the cars emitted from high-density buildings. At this point, the things you see on your screen only give a very distorted image of what is really happening in the SimCity world, and to make it kind of work, you have to compromise the simulation in so many important aspects that having persistent sims and traffic is just not worth it anymore. The current system would work for very small cities that never come close to filling their roads up to capacity, but not for larger ones. In my opinion, that, besides the pathfinding, is the main reason why the size of the patches is so limited. Larger plots would either require to increase the fudge multiplicator even more or to put hundreds of sims into single cars. The magnitude of the problem is so large that fudging a little in all areas is not sufficient. Bottom line, don't wait for Maxis to fix SimCity. It cannot be fixed. It is broken by design. Of course, it's possible I'm overlooking something essential here. Let me know if you think so in the comments, and of course why you think so. Thank you very much for watching. Bye.